Welcome to Kaunas district, the natural oasis at the outskirts of Kaunas city. You'll find Kaunas district municipality all surrounding the city of Kaunas, which is just 100 kilometers away from the capital Vilnius. Kaunas International Airport is also located in Kaunas district, and it is only 20 minutes away from the city center. The population of Kaunas district municipality reaches around 97,500 in 2021, and most of its people work daily in Kaunas city. If you had been to Kaunas and yet you feel like you still need to get out of a city or just to see something close by and more of Kaunas region, then keep watching this video and I will tell you all about the region of Kaunas. If you haven't seen my video about Kaunas city yet, then click the link in the top right corner and check it out after watching this one. Now, let's move on with this video. Kaunas district can be easily traveled not just by car, but also by public transportation. And there is an extensive bicycle path network reaching most of the places that I will mention in this video. The district is mostly known for its natural sites, but it has a lot of historic places too. From natural sites there are the most of Kauno Marios Regional Park, cognitive and bicycle trails, hill forts all around, and some interesting places for outdoor activities. From historical and cultural side, the district is also not neglected. From Gothic architecture to historic towns and forts and even a castle. Let's start with a castle. Easily accessible from Kaunas center is the Raudondvaris castle, although it was built more as a representative one, just like the ones in Jurbarkas district. And I mention it not without a reason. When you start the picturesque Panemunė road trip, this is the first stop if you are starting from Kaunas. You can learn all about this in my video about Jurbarkas district. Raudondvaris castle was built in 17th century in Renaissance style, and throughout the years it belonged to many different noble families until the famous Tiškevich family bought it in the beginning of 19th century and kept it until the First World War. In this time the castle became a luxurious residence. There was a large collection of artworks, rare books, also exotic plant and animal collections. Tiškevich family did a lot of improvements, built another building, an orangery, large stables and more. Unfortunately, everything was set on fire and burned down during the Second World War, but in the 60s it was renovated, and so it stands till today. And today there is a lot to do there. There is Kaunas District Museum inside the castle with a lot of educational programs, a restaurant in the orangery and arts incubator in the stables. There also is tourism information center of the whole district, so it is a perfect spot to get to know all Kaunas district. Raudondvaris is definitely the main culture and community center of Kaunas district. It hosts celebrations for all the major holidays in Lithuania, also numerous concerts and other events. You can reach Raudondvaris by Kaunas public transportation, bike, car, or in the warm months even by boat from Kaunas old town. Next we are going further from Raudondvaris towards the resort town Kulautuva, and we'll stop for a short visit to Netainė Hill. It has a great view and a lookout tower to Nemunas River, but it's famous for another reason. This is a popular place for gliding and paragliding. The first paragliding competition happened here in 1977, which kick-started the paragliding sports in Lithuania. After this we reach Kulautuva town. It is a popular summer place, and it used to be even a resort before the Second World War. It is all surrounded by pine tree forest and settled on Nemunas riverbank. It reminds me a little of Birštinas, a famous resort south from Kaunas. You can watch a video about it by clicking the link in the top right corner. But Kulautuva somehow didn't become as famous. Today Kulautuva is most popular for its natural look and forest hiking trails. There is a cognitive trail with sculptures called the Valley of Gods and Goddesses. There are various wooden sculptures of ancient Baltic gods, a nice way to get to know some of Baltic mythology. For those who are more into water activities, there also is a beach in Kulautuva and a wake park. One more interesting thing about Kulautuva that it hosts a yearly musical festival called Akacijų Alėja. It is all about bard music, sung poetry, ballads and coziness. It happens in early July each year and is free of charge. Next on the road and the last stop before entering Jurbarkas district is a village called Vilkija. It is a place with some of the best views in Kaunas district, and we can see all that at the viewing platform, the beautiful curve of Nemunas River. There also is a nice little park by the river and a river ferry that can take you to the other side in Šakiai district. But in Vilkija there is one more place to stop. It is Antanas and Jonas Juška Ethnic Culture Museum. Antanas Juška, who was a priest, a linguist, a folklorist, lived there in the middle of 19th century. Together with his brother Jonas, he collected a lot of valuable books, glossaries and songbooks. Later, before the Second World War, this small wooden home became the gathering place for many famous writers, artists, composers and other famous people. Today it is a cultural museum and it is still filled with the artist spirit combined with traditional interiors and friendly hosts. And the house itself is around 300 years old. After Vilkija, we leave Jurbarkas Road and go a bit north to reach the highway between Kaunas and Klaipėda to see a peculiar sight. Žalgiris Park. What is Žalgiris, you may ask? Well, it is something every Lithuanian is still proud of. But the short story is that Žalgiris was an important medieval battle in 1410, when combined forces of Lithuania and Poland defeated invading Teutonic Knights. The battle shifted the balance of power in Central and Eastern Europe and marked the rise of the Polish-Lithuanian Union as the dominant political and military force in the region. The park, when passing by, might look just like a simple park with some wooden sculptures, but from above it has a very different look. It is the name Žalgiris, made of trees with a rising sun behind it. Beautiful. From here, let's jump to Neris riverside north of Kaunas. Here you'll find a very inconspicuous and even boring location – urban gardening communities. But that is just a perfect hiding place for someone trying to stay undercover. Inside one of those garden greenhouses, there is an underground publishing house called AB. This is the only one such type hideout in Lithuania that has not been detected by the Soviet security. From here, thousands of religious and patriotic publications were secretly disseminated across the country. Now there's a small museum where you can see and learn how did they manage to avoid being detected by one of the strongest powers in the world at the time. Next we go to the southwest of the district, following a 20-kilometer long bicycle path towards Zapyškis. First stop is Tadas Ivanauskas homestead Obelinė. If you have watched my video about Kauno city, then you have heard of him already. He was a famous biologist and zoologist who established the zoological museum mentioned in the previous video. He also was one of the founders of Kauno Zoo, Botanical Garden and Vytautas Magnus University. Also established Žuvintas Biosphere Reserve mentioned in Alytus District video, and he even established one of the first bird banding stations in Europe at Cape Vente in Šilutė District in 1929. This guy was unstoppable. Anyway, here in Obelinė you can see his home, small museum, and his gardens taking up more than 6 hectares of land, famous for apple trees. Thus the name Obelinė. Obelis is an apple tree in Lithuanian. Beside the apple trees, there are in total more than 300 types of trees. Next on the bicycle road is Piplei Hill Fort. It's a great stop for a rest and to have magnificent views of Nemunas River Valley at the confluence with Nevėžis River. After this, we reach Kačerginė town, a very similar one to Kulautuva, both historically and geographically. It is also settled in a pine tree forest next to the same river. The best way to explore this forest is to go to the Trail of Springs. It's called like this because it has many springs water streams. The trail is 6 kilometers long and takes you to the previously mentioned Piplei Hill Fort. There are shorter versions of the trail too, but it is not one of the easy ones because of all the hills and valleys. If a trail seems too much to you, then just enjoy the forest in one of the campsites, Apokinė and Barsukinė. These are great spots to have a forest picnic, plitka display or just have a peaceful time in the nature. Inside the town itself there are a few parks to enjoy as well. Fairy Tale Park of children books writer Pranas Mišotas, Vincas Mykolaitis Putinas Sculpture Benches Park and Downs Park called Linden Park. From Kačerginė we move on to another small town, this time famous for something completely different. Zapyškis is a town on the opposite side of riverbank from Kulautuva and is known since 16th century. But today it is famous for its beautiful Gothic church built right at the riverbank. It was first mentioned in 16th century, but might be even older. Today it is not only used for prayers, but also concerts and many other events. For example, at the grounds of a church every year there is a kite festival, which normally is held in May, but this year it will happen in August. Next to the church, there is a small port as well, where you can take a tour with a boat that will take you to all these mentioned villages on the riverside, Kačerginė, Kulautuva and Vilkija. There also is a small ferry for pedestrians and cyclists between Kulautuva and Zapyškis. At the time of filming, I was lucky to see some Lithuanian sea scouts traveling with their boats all the way to the Nemunas river mouth in Šilutė district. Now, let's go back closer to the city to see some of rather different sites, the forts. In my previous video about Kaunas, I mentioned the 9th fort, which was inside the city, but there are much more left around, and in Kaunas district it is worth seeing the 1st and 3rd forts, if you are interested in war history. They all were constructed before the First World War. Both of these forts are open for visitors, and if you want more, there you can get guided excursions, educations and more. But it is forbidden to visit indoors from the 1st of October to the 1st of May, in order to save a population of bats living there. From here it's not far to go to the last but not least touristic area in Kaunas district, Kauno Marios Regional Park. You have already heard a lot of it in Kaišiadorys district video, and Kaunas city even talked about Pažaislis monastery. But here is where the most of the park's natural sites are located. First, it is great to visit the visitor center, where you can learn everything about the park. Then, close by, there is Dubrava Arboretum Park, 51 hectares in size, tree and shrubbery park. There are around 1,000 species of plants valuable in scientific, cognitive and decorative respects. On the other side of the road, there is even larger Gironis Park. It also has a wide variety of plants settled into a beautiful landscape park, reaching the bank of Kauno Marios. Throughout the park and leading further, there is Pakalniški Cognitive Trail. The 3 km long trail will lead you to Pakalniški Hill Fort, where you can enjoy amazing views of Kaunas Reservoir. Another famous cognitive trail is Žiegždrė Geological Trail. This mostly wooden path follows the river bank and shows off geological formations of Žiegždrė outcrop, left from the Ice Age. The trail is 1.6 kilometers one way and is a very pretty and serene place for a walk. Another competitor for pretty walks is at the Dubrava Reserve area. Here the landscape is quite a contrast from the others. It is a wooden path throughout a swamp and pine tree forest. The reserve is untouched since 1968, so all you will see there will be the most natural forest. The only intervention is the wooden path through a swamp and a few information stands to read about local fauna and flora. The last cognitive trail and the most popular one in Kaunas district and one of the most beautiful in the whole country is Juniper Valley. The path is leading at the top of a tall riverbank slope, all covered with juniper trees. And the views from the top are just spectacular. You can see a whole different side of Kauno Marios Regional Park. However, there are some important news about this path. It got closed this summer. Due to very high popularity, the path got worn out fast and became dangerous to visit. So if you want to visit, I suggest to wait until it gets renovated, hopefully soon, or join a boat tour from Kaunas and see it together with other beautiful sights in the regional park. And lastly, after all the sightseeing and hiking around, you can have a rest at one of the many campsites on the banks of Kaunas Reservoir. One place in particular to mention is Samyle campsite. There is an interesting wooden sculpture collection named Rising from the Water, dedicated to all the villages that were flooded during the construction of Kaunas Dam. Wow, if you reached this part of the video, then let me know in the comments below which place did you like the most? I had been living in Kaunas in all my youth years and still visiting a lot, but still, I didn't know the sheer volume of all there is to do around here. And there is even more that didn't fit into this video. I highly recommend visiting all of this during your stay in Kaunas if you are able to. Or at least I hope that my video helped you to know more about Kaunas region. See you in Kaunas district. Thanks for watching.